Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at the LEGO City Advent Calendar for 2014. This is a 218 piece set, comes with a whole lot of mini builds and some mini figures. Let's open up the flap on this box, turn the whole thing upside down and reveal the full city scene shown here. Lots of nice building stuff going on in the back, showing some of the current sets, as well as some custom buildings. And you've got a little bit of a park down here where you can set some of the mini builds that are included inside of here. Now, if you don't want to see what's behind each door in this advent calendar, please stop the video. Do not watch it any further. Nobody's forcing you to watch this, but I'm going to go through and open all of these and show you all of the mini builds and mini figures at the same time. We start on day one with a boy with a letter. That could be a letter that he's going to send to the North Pole to tell Santa what he wants to get for Christmas. Day two, appropriately, gives him a mailbox into which to place that letter. Day three is a snowman of very modest size and simple but effective build. Day four brings in a couple of mugs for some nice warm cider or eggnog, and a cream pie. Day five introduces an adult woman with green overalls, long hair in a tail in the back in dark brown, and she's carrying with her, or possibly offering up, a croissant. Not sure whether she's going to be eating that or maybe giving it to the kid. We shall see. Day six has a veritable cornucopia basket with all sorts of fruits and vegetables included in there. Day seven has an outdoor scene on one side and an indoor scene on the other. That's a nice little bow of something that's used for decoration with some little green berries still growing right off it. Might represent holly or something like that. And also a couple of gems that are representing some kind of, you know, nice decoration, some ornaments. Day eight introduces another kid, a very happy girl this time, and she is donning a pair of ice skates, so she's probably having a lot of fun zooming around on some frozen pond that's very safe because it's frozen solid. That's a good thing. Day nine has a large old-style cart with big wooden-spoked old-style wagon wheels, and it has just a relatively smallish container, which right now just has a baguette or loaf of bread in it. Day 10 introduces a device of mischief. This is a little catapult for snowballs. So you take one of these off here, break that off, and put that loaded in, and then you can hit people with it real hard. This policeman will probably make sure things don't get too far out of hand with the catapult, though. However, he's probably mostly focusing on going around as a caroler. He's going to be using his speaker there, his little PA projector, to project his voice. This is something a little different. It's a radio-controlled toy duck with the radio controller to go with it. So this is something you can play with during the winter time, especially if you've got a frozen pond nearby, because you can just drive it around on the top of that and make it look like it's a duck that's actually swimming. We're now on day 13, and this is a troubling development. This is a criminal who's got his flashlight there. He's probably going around trying to rob houses when people leave their houses to go to family members' gatherings for the holidays, and he's going and looking in the windows and things, and he is trying to steal stuff from folks. He's already picked up this nice red gem. Day 14, in contrast, brings us something that's very innocent. It's just a small one-person sled. Day 15 brings us this dog, along with a bowl with a couple bones in it. There's a little bit of print on the nose and top of the head. This could be a German Shepherd dog, or you could imagine it to be some other species. You could consider this to be a pet, or it could be a police dog. Day 16 introduces just the tiniest little snow machine or snowmobile in cop colors, police colors. This is actually a small mobility device for police to get around during the winter months when there's lots of snow around. And this actually has a little tow hitch on the back, and we'll see what that's for right here. This is just a little sled that can be pulled behind the snow machine. And you see, it looks like it'll probably hold a minifigure and some extra cargo in the back. Day 18 introduces another cop. And this guy has a nice warm smile on his face, but it looks like he may be a little bit more serious right now because he does have a pair of handcuffs at the ready and also a spare. By the way, there's what the police torso looks like from the back if you haven't seen these latest versions of police from LEGO City. This is what you get on day 19. It's time for a feast with a big old turkey with a couple of drumsticks that can be broken off. And you've got a, I'm gonna call that a Martinelli's sparkling cider bottle back there, yeah. And a couple of wine glasses to enjoy that wonderful non-alcoholic beverage. Day 20 seems to be all about work because you've got a couple of axes here that were used to chop up some wood, and you have a barrel which can be used to hold the tools, or it can be used as a rubbish or trash bin, and you have a couple of shovels to, well, mostly shovel up snow. Day 22 is about rewarding your hard work, as you have a nice gift there, and also a stuffed stocking, or that could be a giant candy cane. With day 22 comes the Christmas tree, and this one is very modest in size, but it looks nice. It has all different colored transparent ornaments all around it, and it's got the nice gem up on the top, although you probably have to worry about that getting stolen by that one robber, that one criminal who's on the loose in this city. Day 23 sure introduces something cool. It's a large-sized children's tricycle in the classic red and white colors. It's got a lot of rake to it. It's pretty cool looking. We'll have to see what it looks like with a minifigure trying to ride it. Last up is Santa Claus himself, and he's got a big old satchel, presumably full of gifts. He's also got a cookie that has presumably been left for him by some nice family. So we'll go ahead and take a look at him from all angles so you can see exactly what he looks like. No print on the back, but you can still look at the hat and the shape of it and the way that that's done in dual tone there, with the red being applied over the white. The red is actually a little bit darker, you can see, of the hat compared to the color of the suit, you know, the body, the torso, the legs and arms. But I also want to show you what the rest of this guy looks like with the beard removed. So he's just got a pretty plain, regular, nice smile underneath there, and that also lets you see the rest of the print of the top of his suit. So here's everything kind of laid out on the package and the scene, the kind of city scene that's made with that. You use the flap as the ground section, kind of makes for a faux play mat, or a little bit of a base plate, if you will. It has no studs on it, though. You see some stuff going on around this part of town, including Santa being pulled around on a different sleigh. He was rescued. I guess his main one broke down. He was rescued by the cops, who are now taking him around while also caroling and being raced by this kid on his tricycle. So there you see how that worked out. In the background, I went ahead and got the criminal captured very quickly, so he's not going to be stealing any more stuff or ruining Christmas for anybody. Got a little bit of the indoor scene there with the feast set up and the tree back there over on the side. And there's a little bit more of just what's in the front yard and kind of on the corner. You can kind of look at this as being a cul-de-sac, and the letter is in the mailbox getting ready to be delivered, and that takes care of it for the 2014 LEGO City Advent Calendar. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed that. Hope that you will have a wonderful holiday season, and I hope that you will come back for more videos from me, because I'm always coming out with new ones. Talk to you again soon.